three areas that we're looking at, similar to the three pillars that you talked about. One would be our workplace. The second would be healthcare. And so how do we create inclusive healthcare where we're able to address many of the differences in outcomes or the disparities that we see with certain populations? And then the third would be our community. And we think about that in similar ways from kind of our broad community and how we invest in the community, how we increase vitality in our communities, and as well, you know, from a supplier diversity standpoint. You know, this conversation that we've started having in our organization around diversity, equity, inclusion in much more meaningful ways is really interesting. And so, you know, some people, I think, have to come around to understanding some of the differences between diversity, inclusion, equity, and what those words really mean. And so as we, you know, you talked about progress and things that you experienced and were able to do over your career in all three of those fronts, maybe if you can talk a little bit about just the differences between the words diversity and inclusion and how they show up in an organization or in our communities.
That's a great question, by the way, Greg, and congratulations on your role as the leader for diversity, equity, and inclusion. I'm excited about your strategy, and I'm already excited about the many accomplishments that your hospital has already made in that space. You know, with I can just go on. You know, you're making sure that you speak the right language for your patients. The religion strategy that you have with your patients, it's just very, very impressive. And your leadership team. Oh my goodness, I looked at your board, your leaders. You know, it's diverse, a lot of women. You know, you always need a lot of good estrogen on your team. You know that, right? And then, of course, I'd like to see a few more women of color at the top. But you guys are definitely on the right road. But now let me talk about diversity, equity, and inclusion. So you've heard, everybody's heard that old saying, you know, diversity is they're all, you've invited them there, and inclusion is now they can dance. Well, let me tell you the difference. It's not just about gender, you know, ethnicity, and so forth. Let me tell you about a clear difference between diversity and inclusion. We're a technical company, but we were so focused on engineers, Greg. And I got a chance to run one of the largest factories. We were making the 787. And you know, we were in a union conversation because the mechanics didn't feel like they were included. Inclusion, it's all about engineering. And so I had to change the cultural norms in that site to say, if we're a non-union environment, our mechanics are just as important, just as valuable as the engineering community. This is a diversity and inclusion conversation. So we had plenty of mechanics, but they were not part of the innovative culture in our company. So we opened it up where we set up innovation centers around the entire plant. And the mechanics, where they saw a bad design, can come to these centers and pencil out a concept, even learn the design tools and come up with solutions. And the first year we deployed that, there was more patents actually filed by the mechanics, especially farmers, than the engineers. So when you don't maximize the full utilization of your entire workforce, even know what you have, you got to do an inventory of your actual talent. I have to tell you, we became the supplier of choice. And as you know, there was two 787 factories, one in Everett, one in Charleston. The Charleston one is with all the patents. They're moving the entire program to Charleston. And we dramatically reduce the cost. That's the power of diversity and inclusion. You can do the same thing with ethnicity, with gender, and so forth. If you just stretch every individual and maximize their full potential in your work environment and bring the diversity of it, instead of having multiple pictures, have a mosaic, you become the hospital of choice. And equity, for example, if you're not looking at the disparity between women's pay and men's pay within the hospital and how they do it, it's another opportunity. And by the way, if you're going to the same suppliers and there's no diversity that represents the community, that's an equity play. And I love the fact that you're looking at the healthcare disparity. right now, my new career is that I have a company in data science, and we're looking at changing the face of algorithms and the bias in algorithms, because we know that there's disparity, big disparity in the healthcare. You know, if it's clinical trials, if it's, you know, how we prescribe medicine, there's a lot of analytics that are in that equation. And it's a huge opportunity for us to change the face again in the disparity in healthcare. So, you know, and that's by data. I mean, you have to not just have a bunch of activity around diversity. You have to be very intentional. You know, look at our healthcare and the survey instruments that you're going to deploy on how people are being treated. You know, what does my board makeup look like? What is my supplier base with analytics, and then predictive analytics on how you can change that equation?